What's up, guys? Joe here, and today I'm getting a haircut that I've never gotten before. Sure, it borrows some similarities from fades that you've seen in the past, but today it's all about the burst. And as you saw from the intro, we are still hard at work on making Inuko become a reality. More about what we were up to towards the end of this video. Now, what I'm really excited to show you guys today is Ariel, who is actually given the haircut. She goes by Boss Baby Blends on Instagram, gives killer cuts, and is the official lead barber stylist at Inuko once we open our doors up to the public. So give her some love on Instagram, and once you start seeing some killer haircuts coming out of Inuko, just know she's partly responsible. So if it wasn't clear enough from the name of the haircut, to put it in basic terms, a burst fade is simply a fade that bursts outward in a semicircle type of way. And this requires a little more technical skill than a standard fade, since the fade isn't simply going up and down, rather outward. And making sure to line it up in a way that looks clean with a smooth transition, that's not something that you're learning on day two of barber school. Now, you guys have already seen my full-on embracement of more unusual haircuts over the past 7 to 8 months. And honestly, I mean, it's just that. I am thoroughly enjoying stepping outside the conventional norms of classically safe styles. The burst fade is also an easy transition from a mullet because to do it correctly, you need a little extra length towards the back to highlight the burst effect fully. So no, my hair towards the back definitely isn't in mullet territory anymore, but it's still unconventional in the sense that the fade isn't mirrored towards the bottom of my neck area. A little extra length for added texture during styling is what it's all about right now. As for the top, we're cutting it down and texturizing it enough for me to wear it more messy and forward. That's kind of my 2022 thing at the moment, just more texture and less styling effort, just really embracing the messy. And from there, it is all about the styling. I re-wet my hair off camera so we could really build in that volume from the ground floor using a blow dryer. And one thing that I really appreciate about Ariel is that she really makes sure to dry your hair fully during the styling process. Sometimes stylists leave your hair a little damp, which makes the style not hold up as long, but getting it fully dried down keeps the volume lasting all day. I know it doesn't sound like much, but these are just the little things I'm picking up on when considering how to make sure that we can provide an awesome service once doors are open. And just like that, we got the burst fade with a disconnect fully completed and styled. If anything, I hope this can encourage you to step outside the box a little and think about all the options you have when it comes to hairstyles and haircuts. I'm loving the experimentation, and I hope that you enjoy watching it happen. The journey of Inuko has been unlike anything else. It's crazy to think that this idea was sparked nearly 2 years ago, but to see where we've gotten to makes the stressful days all the more worth it. And what you're seeing here is our latest recruitment day. We're talking to different barbers, sharing the vision, and taking every step that brings us closer to launch. And not to mention, since the last time you saw this place on camera, the walls have been knocked down and the floors have been fitted with Italian tile. Just a little sneak peek into what will become a place unlike anything that you've ever seen in the barber world before. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you next time.